Hi, I'm David Stiernholm. Isn't it horrible when you have many meetings back to back, day after day, so that you have hardly time to do other things or even leave an ending meeting before the next one begins? One way to avoid this stressful situation that is oh so common is to add time buffers immediately before and after a meeting when you book it. This will give you more space between the meetings. You will stress less and have more time to think and prepare yourself for what's next. But isn't this yet another trick that you have to remember? Another habit to establish? Doesn't implementing this add even more to your workload when you have already too much to do? Well, luckily, you can let these time buffers be added automatically without any effort on your part. I'll show you how. If you are an Office 365 user, let Microsoft Flow add the time buffers for you. Create a new automated flow from blank. Choose when an event is added, updated, or deleted in Outlook as your flow's trigger. Select your calendar. If you want to add buffers only for certain meetings, add a control that only continues the flow if the newly added meeting is of this particular kind, for instance, a project meeting. If it's not, let the flow terminate. And if it is a project meeting, create a new event, which is the pre-meeting buffer. And calculate the buffer start time through the add minutes expression. Set the buffer's end time to the project meeting's start time. Also, add another action that creates another new event, the post-meeting buffer, that is. This time, set the buffer start time to the meeting's end time and calculate the buffer's end time through the add minutes expression again. And now, you're all set. From now on, when you add a new project meeting to your calendar, the two time buffers will be added automatically. If you're not an Office 365 user, but instead use another calendar platform, let the automation service Zapier add the time buffers. In Zapier, make a new Zap. Choose Chronify Calendar Connector as your trigger app and Event Creative as your trigger. Select your calendar. Add a filter if you want to add buffers only for certain meetings, just like before. Add a formatter action that calculates the start time for the pre-meeting buffer and another for the end time for the post-meeting buffer. Then, add the actions that create the actual buffers. Again, choose Chronify Calendar Connector and a Create Event action. Name the pre-meeting buffer in Summary. Set the start time to the time we calculated earlier and the end time to the actual meeting's start time. Thank you. and add another similar action for creating the post-meeting buffer. And now you're all set. When you add a new project meeting to your calendar, the two time buffers will be added automatically. There's plenty of more simplifying ideas like this in my new book that's out now. Thanks.